Come on in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's Testimony Tuesday live time. Come on in. Yes. Come on in, and as you're coming in, you know, here on Testimony Tuesday live, we hit that share button so that everyone else on your page can know that it's Testimony Tuesday live time. Come on in. Yes. We're listening to You're Amazing by Ricky Dillard and the new Amazing. You are amazing. Hey, Ingrid. Hey. Hey, hey, hey. Come on in, come on in. It's Testimony Tuesday live time. As you're coming in, I need you to hit that share button for me, please. We're listening to You're Amazing by Ricky Dillard. One of my favorite songs. He's telling about God, how amazing he is. So come on in, and as you're coming in, hit that share button. Hit that share button. Yes. Come on in. Yes. He's amazing. He's amazing. Come on in. Yes. Okay, my cousin Brenda CYB. Okay, hello. Welcome. Thank you for joining me live. I guess I got that right. You all, come on in. While you're coming in, hit the share button. Let everybody know it's Testimony Tuesday live time. Come on in. I pray that you've already had an amazing, amazing day. Just knowing who God is all along by itself is an amazing, amazing day. Yes. Open your mouth and exalt him. Yes, come on in. I do not own the rights to the music, but I have permission to play it as an opening praise song. Come on. Yes. Come on in. Here we go. No one compares to you. Yes. No one compares to him. How about this? Yes. Yes. You're amazing. You're amazing. No one compares to you. How many of y'all believe that no one compares to Jesus? Yes. I like this part right here. Can't nobody hold me. Yes. Hello, crowd on Facebook. Come on, get your share button. You're amazing. Yes. You're amazing. Yes, God is amazing. Come on in. Yes, he's been good to us. Yes. Yes, give me some shout emojis if God's been good to you. When you look back over your life. Oh, come on, girl. Yes. 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 Come on in, hit the share button. Yes. In the midnight hour, she say. Yes, come on in. Come on in. Yes. You've been so good to me. Make you want to take out running and shout. Yes. Me and you, yes. Come on now. Yes. Yes. The healing power, I can testify. come on in, come on in. Well, good afternoon. Good afternoon, good afternoon, and welcome to Testimony Tuesday Live. As I was saying in the beginning, I pray that you've already had a blessed, blessed day thus far. Welcome to Testimony Tuesday Live. I am Anita Johnson Merchant, known as the Prayer Advocate. I am sold out to prayer. And why do I say that? It's because of Psalms 116 and 2, Amplified Version. And it simply says this: because he bends down to listen, I will pray as long as I have breath. How many of you can say that you have someone that bends down to listen to you when you speak, or when you pray, or when you do the things that you do? How many of us can really say? But he tells us that in Psalms 116 and 2, and that's why I am sold out to prayer. Now, what do I do as the prayer advocate? I help educate, equip, and encourage those of women with all walks of life who have no prayer life, and who wants to establish one and learn how to maintain the consistency. Right now, I'm in a session of the Prayer Incubator course, which is what I use to help women establish and maintain their personal prayer life, which is what brings your relationship with God. So today, I just want to mention that the next session for the Prayer Incubator will be January 22nd. Once this one is finished, we're going to take a break, and then it will start again on January 22nd of 2024. So make note of that. I want to thank you all who have joined my YouTube channel, those of you who have been giving me thumbs up, those of you who have subscribed, and those of you who are sharing. I appreciate you, and continue to visit my YouTube channel, Anita J. Merchant. When you get a chance, you can always see all the previous Testimony Tuesday Lives and other things that I'm posting that I don't post on other platforms. So go over there and check me out and subscribe and give your girl a thumbs up. I want to thank all of you who continue to support me on Facebook and Instagram, and then my TikTok family. You guys are really growing, so I thank you all for reaching out the way that you reach out, commenting, and the things that you do over there on TikTok. I just want to say thank you. All this month, I have been posting the Word of God about joy, right? And so those of you who have been reading, you'll notice that I've been posting on every platform the God's word about the words of joy. Remember, God is concerned about the joy of our life. And so in his word, he talks so much about joy, how to have joy, and what joy is. And so for the month of October, I posted every day a scripture from the word of God about joy. A lot of you have inboxed me saying thank you, that you normally wouldn't read God's word every day, but just getting that one post and reading it has helped you start to develop reading God's word every day. And it's so important that you read God's word every day, because that's how you maintain your relationship. So I want to send hats off. Bravo. Today was day 30. I've posted the post already. Day 30 of the 30 days of you reading God's word every day on joy. So my hats go off, and bravo, claps to those of you who have been reading, those of you who have been reaching out, those of you who have been sharing. I appreciate you. God has given me a new task for the month of November, and I'll be posting a video going live later today explaining to you what November month will contain and what will be going on for the month of November. So be on the lookout for that. It's time for prayer box giveaway. You know how we do. We do a little drum roll. In the prayer box giveaway, here's the one thing that you have to do in order to be considered for the prayer box. Message me the name and the address of someone you know would benefit from the prayer box. That's all you have to do, is message me the name and their address. We're going to surprise them and send them the mail prayer box saying that you were the one who felt that they would be beneficial with receiving the prayer box. Now, this is not going to cost you anything, just a little bit of your time. There has to be someone in your life that you know would benefit from a prayer box, and all you have to do is send me their name and their address, and we're going to surprise them. I'm going to just mail them the prayer box with a little note in there saying that you recommended and felt that they would need or could benefit from the prayer box. It's just that simple. Hey, Terrell, and thank you for joining me. All you have to do for the Proud Box giveaway. We're going to step out of self and we're going to do for something for someone in our life that we know would benefit from a Proud Box. So here's all you have to do. Message me their name and their address, and we're going to surprise them and send it to them. So I want to encourage you, think about someone in your life or someone that you know. It could be somebody at your church, somebody in y'all little clique groups, you know, y'all group of women, whoever, whatever. Yo, it could be one of your children. It could be your neighbor. It could be your pastor's wife. It could be anybody who you know would benefit from a Prayer Box. Message me the name and address of someone who you know could benefit. So let's have a shout out moment. I want to say shout out and bravo, bravo to all of you all who have been reading the 30 days of God's word on joy. Yes. Hands claps to you that you've taken the time to make sure that you read God's word every day. It's so, so important. I can't stress this enough that you read something in God's word every day. So I share with, I had a testimony that I want to share with you all before I get into the Holy Spirit led for the word for today. Just bear with me. I had a conversation with a long friend a couple of days ago, and she asked me this question. She said, how do you keep and stay motivated to do the things that you do for God's glory? And I was like, whoa, okay. Y'all, I had to take a few deep breaths. I had to breathe and really think about that answer before I answered her. And so as I was thinking about how do I stay motivated, how would you stay motivated to be able to continue to serve God, do what God has called you to do, the anointing he has put on your life, how do you stay motivated and how do you maintain the consistency or you keep doing it day after day? Well, today is a prime example. I'm going to share this testimony with you. Today, I really did not feel like doing Testimony Tuesday. As you can see the way that I'm dressed, I am dressed the way that I am relaxed at home today. Now, I'm not going to have this hat on when I finish Testimony Tuesday. I'm going to just be back into my bomb situation and just enjoying. I love the cold weather, and it's cold here where I am. I love the cold weather, and I think that's because I was born in December. I love the cold weather. I love the fact that you can bundle, you can put on layers, and you can just really enjoy the crisp blowing of the wind and the smell of the fresh air. I just love the wintertime. And so today it is really cold here where I live. It's an overcast day. The wind is blowing. So it's really cold. But when I woke up this morning, I really did not feel like doing Testimony Tuesday. I wanted to stay in my PJs, continue to sip on my coffee and my tea or whatever. I had made some chicken tortilla soup yesterday. And so I want to just eat my soup. And I just want to be a bomb and relax today. But comes back to my testimony. I have to stay focused and keep moving forward on what God has called me to do. And how do I do that? And so I was sharing this with this friend. So here are some things that I do to stay motivated, to continue to do what God say, because trust me, it's not easy serving God. It's not even easy staying in the will of God. It's not easy doing God's work. It's just not easy. And if anybody tell you who has been anointed and appointed to do what God has called them to do, and they say it's easy, it's just a breeze, you may just want to kind of like pass that up, because God says in his word, we're going to have trials and we're going to have tribulations. Meaning when you serve him, you give him that yes, and you want to do what he's called you to do, you need to be prepared to know that you're going to wake up some days and mornings and really don't want to do it, but you're going to persevere and push forward. So some of the things that I do is I have to stay rooted in God's word. I have to meditate on God's word. I have to. I don't have a choice, because if I don't, then I won't continue to do what he's called me to do. I cannot do God's calling on my life properly without a consistent prayer life. You got to have a prayer life to serve God. You have to have a prayer life to do the will of God. You have to have a prayer life to stay out of sin. You have to have a prayer life with an open mind in order to stay communicated and connected with God in order to do his will. If you think about when you're reading God's word and you read about Jesus, Jesus had to stay connected to God to be able to do anything, from performing miracles, from changing water into wine, all those things. He had to stay connected. And that's why you read throughout the word of God how Jesus went often to a quiet place to pray, to get into his Father's presence. That's how he was able to continue to do what he was called to do. That's how he was able to die on the cross for me and you. You have to have a made up mind. No matter what comes your way, you have to have a made up mind that this is what God has called me to do, and so I have to do it. You just have to have a made up mind. You have to keep in the forefront. You're going to do what God instructs you to do and not what your flesh tells you to do. You have to constantly pray that your flesh does not lead you and that you let the Holy Spirit lead you through God. You just have to keep that in the forefront. You have to have some anchor scripture, something that you can anchor on every day. I mean, every day, not sometimes, but every day. And one of mine is, don't get weary in well-doing. I say this often to myself, like this morning when I woke up and I was like, Lord, I do not want to do Testimony Tuesday. I want to be lazy today. I want to just be in my PJs. I want to eat my tortilla soup. I want to drink my coffee and my teas. And I just don't want to do nothing. And the Holy Spirit was like, well, no, Anita, remember you said yes. You gave God your word. And so however you got to do it, you need to get up and do it. And so this is how I am today. Just real laid back. Normally I dress up for Jesus because I want to represent him in a high quality. But the beauty of this is this. He loves me still the way that I am right now. And he still accepts me doing his will. So I thank God for that. And then last but not least, in order to continue to do what God has called you to do, if you're walking in his will, doing what Holy Spirit leads you to do, you have to be able to love God's people right where they are. Even if you don't agree with it, even if you don't like it, even if you don't understand, you still have to just love God's people right where you are. So those are some things I shared with my friend because she said, I just noticed you're so consistent and you just get up and you do the things and you move and you just, and I said, it's not by my strength that I do it. It's by God's strength that he gives me, not by my might and not by my will. And so I wanted to share that with you all today because we have to be reminded if we're going to do what God said or called or anointed you to do, you just have to be able to say yes and keep it moving, even when you have those days and moments, because you will have those days and moments on, you will have those days and moments where you do not want to do what God has called you to do. So that leads into the topic at hand today for the Holy Spirit-led word. Let's get into it, but let's pray first. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, for a gorgeous, miraculous day. Even if the sun is not shining, it's still a beautiful day. We thank you, Lord, for being our God who controls and roams boldly over the earth. We thank you, God. We thank you for being our everything. We thank you for being our provider. We thank you for being our Heavenly Father. We thank you for being our earthly Father. We just thank you for being who you are. We thank you for your darling son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for the Holy Spirit. We just say thank you, Father. Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you saw fit to let us see another day. We thank you, Lord. Father, if there's anything we've already done, thought, or did that was out of your will or against your way, forgive us right now in the name of Jesus. As I move forward, Lord God, I ask that you totally remove me out of the way. Move my mind out of the way and let the Holy Spirit consume and take over, Father. And as we go forward, Lord, we just say thank you, thank you, thank you. It's in Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. So today's Holy Spirit-led word is this. Meditation on God's word. Meditation on God's word. The what, the why, and the how. The what is meditation? Why do we meditate and how we meditate? There are many forms of meditation in the Bible. The Bible reveals God's thoughts and his ways. That's what the Bible basically does. So what is meditation? Meditation is something everyone can do. It does not discriminate. You don't have to have a degree. You don't have to have a big title. You don't have to be a member of a certain church. You don't have to sing in the choir. You don't have to be the usher or the greeter or the person that just comes to church and sit on the pew. Meditation on God's word is open to everyone, and everyone can do meditation. I look at meditation, and as I was studying and preparing for this, it's like a vacation for your mind. That's what meditation really is. It gives your mind a break of everyday things that you deal with, ins and outs, from the time you rise up until you go to bed. Meditation is basically a vacation from all of that, meaning that you fill your mind with the truth, God's word, God's character, God's promises, and God's instruction. That's basically what meditation is. It is not all that deep, and it doesn't have to be difficult. We make it that way just because when we hear the word meditation, we immediately freeze up and think that we have to have a PhD to meditate. I'm here to tell you, you do not. So why do we meditate? And this is very important and interesting because a lot of people say they don't meditate because they don't know why. They don't know why. They just hear that you should meditate. So here's some reasons why you should meditate on God's word. To hear God's voice. It's a deeper understanding of God. When you meditate, it's a deeper understanding you get to hear his voice clearly. Another reason is it helps us to be obedient. It's a spiritual growth. You sin less. You don't want to think about the wrong things or do the wrong things when you meditate on God's word. Another reason is it strengthens us to follow God's instructions. When he gives us something to do or tell us to do something, it strengthens us to be able to do it because we are meditating on his word. The greater knowledge and wisdom that we can have in life of this lifetime on earth is God's word. It increases your faith. See, your faith be fulfilled and fed and constantly reminded when you're meditating on God's word. And in Romans 10 and 17, we all know this, and people quote this scripture all the time. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith cometh by hearing, but listen at this, hearing the word of God. In meditation, you will hear the word of God because you're meditating, you're listening to it, or you're reading it and trying to digest it into your spirit. Another why is it fills your mind and heart with the promises of God. You won't know the promises of God if you're not meditating on his word. You won't know the promises of God if you're not reading and studying his word daily. Now, you may think you would know the promises of God because you go to church every Sunday or because you do things in the church or ministry or whatever. That's not enough to really know the promises of God. Those are promises that people are speaking of what they've read or heard of the promises of God. But for you to get the promises of God in your spirit and for yourself, you need to meditate on the word of God. We have gotten lazy. People get lazy and they don't want to read the word of God. They want to rely on the sermon on Sunday. They want to rely on calling on a prayer line. They want to rely on somebody telling them what the scripture was. I just said faith come by hearing and hearing the word of God, and they want to just rely on that. But how do you know faith come by hearing if you're not reading and meditating on the word of God? It definitely helps with your prayer life. Yeah, I'm saying it. You know, it always comes back around to prayer. It helps you with your prayer life, meaning you will be able to pray God's word back to him. If you want God to move on earth, send heaven down on earth, pray his word back to him. Pray his promises that he says to you that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Pray your promise to him where he say, greater is he that is in thee than he that is in the world. So you won't know those things to pray back to him if you're not meditating on his word. It's not enough just to go to church on Sunday, get the sermon, take all of the pretty notes in your book and your Bible, and then you do nothing else from Monday to Saturday until you go back on Sunday. That's not meditating on God's word. It transforms your mind because, see, your mind is what has to be transformed. And if you meditate on God's word every day, your mind can't help but be transformed. Your mind will be transformed to where you will know the difference in God's voice and the adversary voice. Your mind will be transferred where you will know who to go to when you need this or when you need that versus running to somebody here on earth. See, your mind will be transformed and send you to where you need to go to get what you need. Not saying that the people on earth is not here to help one another and support one another, but that's different. But when you really need to know who to go to in them dark night hours or them crying moments when you just don't know what you're going to do, you need to be meditating on God's word because you'll know where to go to get what you need. It transforms your mind. In Matthew 4:4, it says this. But he answered, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. How am I going to know everything that comes from the mouth of God? Meditating on his word. So we've talked about what is meditation and why we meditate. Now we're going to talk about how do you meditate? The number one thing is to find a place to sit where you feel calm and the place is quiet. You cannot meditate on God's word with a whole lot of talking and noise going around. I know people say, oh, I can do it 2-3 things at one time. I can multitask and I can get several things done at one time. That is not meditating. I'm just here to tell you. And you can read God's word a little bit more for him to really explain to you what meditation is. But you need to have a quiet, calm place where you can relax while you're meditating and reading and studying God's word. In Psalms 119:15-16, here is what it says. I will meditate on your precepts and consider your ways. I delight in your decrees. I will not neglect your word. Again, that was Psalm 119:15-16. So sidebar. I teach about this in more detail in the Prayer Incubator Signature Course. I teach those who are enrolled on the meditation and how to bring it about into your daily life and how to set up a place to where it could just be your place where you and Jesus meet all the time. I talk about that all the time. And have you ever thought about this? Have you ever thought about why you have your own space on the job? You know, you have a cubicle or you have an office. Have you ever thought about why you really have those things? Why your employer set those spaces and those things up for you? It's because they want you to focus and study and be into whatever you are doing right then without interruptions. That's really why. And that comes back with the same thing with the word of God. You want to be in a place, in a space that's quiet and calm where you can totally digest, breathe, release, relax, and allow the word to consume you and you meditate on it. That's basically what it is. Other ways to meditate is read a passage of God's word. Select a certain passage. Are you in a book of Romans? Book of Ephesians, book of Zephaniah, or any book that you choose to read the passage in that book or that scripture. You do that to help you focus, maintain a calmness, and maintain your mind to be consumed to what you're actually reading. That's how you really meditate. It requires uninterrupted time. You can't meditate on God's word, like I say, and multitask. I'm sorry. You may be thinking that you are good at multitasking and that you can meditate on God's word and multitask, but I'm here to just help you out that you cannot multitask when you're meditating on God's word. You're either going to meditate on his word, let the Holy Spirit consume you, let your mind be consumed, your body, soul, your spirit, or you're going to try to see what he's saying and then read this or listen to this TV show or have this playing in the background or doing another product. You know, some people say, well, I meditate on God's word when I'm doing this and when I'm doing that. But you got to use some of your brain and your mind to do whatever that other thing is. So how are you totally giving God 100% of your attention? Just something for you to think about. That's all I'm going to say. Then it's in another way meditate is have a journal, have something you can write on, because the Holy Spirit is going to speak to you. If you're giving it 100% abiding of your attention, the Holy Spirit is going to speak to you about that passage, whatever you're reading. It's going to speak to you. And there are some things that you may want to remember or may have to go back to. So have a journal with you when you are meditating on God's word, when you're in that space and you're sitting still and your passage, whatever you're reading about, analyze that thing, break it down so that you can really understand. Let me sidebar here. Stop relying on other people to explain the word of God to you. Nothing wrong with that, because we're all teachers of the word of God. But take the time to get the explanation from the Holy Spirit also, because when people are talking or teaching, like I'm right here now, Holy Spirit is using me. The Holy Spirit is using me to dissect and share this with you all according to what I've studied and some things that I've come up with. Not saying that it's right or wrong, but you want to get it directly from God. You want to get the Holy Spirit to let it speak into you, let you dissect and analyze that scripture so you have something to write on. Because I promise you, when you get into this habit, you're going to go back to some things and say, oh yeah, I remember this is what the Holy Spirit was trying to tell me. Keep in mind, questions that you may have about a passage that you read, and you can write the question down, go back to it later if you don't have time at the time that you're meditating. Keep in mind, meditation is simple. It doesn't have to be complicated, but you have to get into the Word of God to meditate on the Word of God. The benefit you gain from meditation is a constant mind transformation in order to guide you, help you walk through this life that we're here enduring. Remember, meditation does not have to be complicated, does not have to be perfect. It's a matter of sitting down, having some still time with God's word. You need to make sure you have his word with you. And you pull out something from his word every day and you meditate on day and night. You know that scripture, meditate on it day and night. Not saying you're going to just sit all day and meditate day and night. Sometimes you may have that time where you do that. But it is not complicated. It is very simple. As I close, you know it always comes back around to your prayer life with me. I'm going to have something to say about your prayer life. Meditation is a prayer life builder. Your prayer life will become stronger and stronger and stronger. And you will want to do it more and more and more the more that you meditate on God's word. There's a reason God put that in his word. Meditate on my word day and night. Because he wants your mind to be on him. Your soul, body, and spirit to be fed by him. So that when the adversary comes to try to convince you to sin or to do whatever you know is not the will of God, you will always have something that you can open up your mouth and speak back to him and let him know. Remember God. Remember Jesus used the word of God as a powerful tool whenever he was confronted by the adversary. Your prayer life will become stronger and consistent with meditating on God's word. So let's go boldly to the throne of grace about meditation and asking God to help us to be reminded that meditation is a major part of our relationship with God. Dear God, we thank you for the word that has went forth. And we thank you for how you allow us to be able to have your word to read, to know exactly what you require or call us to do. And meditation is part of it, Father. You say in your word to meditate on your word day and night. And so, Father, we come to you today and we thank you for the opportunity just to hear something about your word on meditation. Father, as we move forward, Lord, we first want to ask you to forgive us if we haven't even already meditated on your word or been into your presence today or had prayer time with you or had some quiet time with you. Father, forgive us if we just jumped up and moved about our own personal schedule, our own way, doing our own thing. Father, we ask you to forgive us right now in the name of Jesus. Father, and moving forward, we're going to make some time, put in every effort to meditate on your word, to have some quiet time with you, to be able to read your scriptures and analyze and allow the Holy Spirit to pour into us what we need to get from that word that we read this day. Father, let us not go a day moving forward without meditating and having your word in our presence and to be able to transform our mind to hear and do what you have called us to do. Father, we ask you right now in the name of Jesus, where we put meditation, that we just look at it as getting into your presence, reading your word, studying your word, and allowing you to speak to us like never before. Father, we say thank you. Father, we thank you that we, the people in the United States of America, we have the free option. We have the free time to be able to meditate on your word. We don't have to hide that we know who Jesus Christ is. We don't have to hide the Bible. We can pull the Bible out boldly wherever we are to read and study and meditate on your word. Father, if we've taken that for granted, forgive us. Let us not continue to take your word, meditating on your word for granted, Father. We ask you to continue to cover us and keep us and remind us, Lord, to stay in your word, to keep it in the forefront. So when the adversary does come, we can open up our mouths and speak and tell him what we've studied and what the Holy Spirit has given us to be able to speak boldly about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We say thank you, Father. Lord, we thank you for meditation. We thank you. Meditation is free. It doesn't cost us anything. God, we thank you, Lord God, that we can come to you We can sit into your presence. We can meditate on your word, and there's nothing anyone can do about it. So we just say thank you, Father. Thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy that you speak to us through your word while we're meditating. Thank you for your prayer that you give us as we meditating and studying your word. Thank you, Father. Thank you for everything that you give us in the word of God, your word, all that we need to be able to have a relationship with you, to be able to communicate with you, to be able to meditate on your word, to be able to pray to you. We say thank you today, Father. Lord, we dare not. Thank you for your darling son, Jesus Christ, who made it possible for us to be able to meditate on your word day and night. We say thank you. Father, I ask that those can hear the sound of my voice and those who listen to the replay, that they in some way have a mind transformation where they shift their time and their lives to include and bring about meditation into their day-to-day life. Let them see the beauty that comes behind meditating on your word. Let them see how their minds will change, their spirits will be fed, their souls will be blessed. I ask you this right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, we glorify you, we give you the highest praise of hallelujah, and we say thank you. It's in Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Remember this, you all. Let nothing good or bad interrupt your consistent prayer life. You all be blessed and have an amazing, amazing rest of the day. Enjoy. Yes. Yes. Thank you all for watching. Thank you, my Facebook family. Thank you, Instagram. Yes. Don't forget, include some meditation in your day-to-day life. You will be surprised how your life will change. It doesn't have to be complicated. There's no confusion behind it. It's just simply getting the word of God, reading it, meditating on it. Have your nice little journal to write down what the Holy Spirit speaks to you. Because when you constantly go to God on a daily basis, you will get to learn His word and know every move you make, He will order it for you. If you're struggling in your meditation, if you're struggling in your prayer life, if you're just struggling with getting into the presence of God, or spending time with Him, you need to just pray, open up your mind and your heart, and ask God to just pour into you what you need to know to put that into your schedule. Your schedule should never be too busy. I don't care if it's 5 minutes or 10 minutes. You can still meditate on God's word. And the beauty of it is, it's all free. So we thank God for the freedom that we have to meditate on His word. Be blessed, you all. Remember, God loves you.